Hello, good afternoon, everyone. Before we start the presentation here, let me introduce myself. So my name is Subhajit, and I'm one of the managers with Zoho Support. Currently, I'm overseeing pre-sales and support operations for Zoho Begin. And before the start of the presentation, let's go ahead and watch a very small video here.
What is Begin? Begin is a simple CRM for small businesses to manage their business seamlessly, right from gathering contacts to closing various business deals. It helps you visualize how the deals progress in the sales pipeline, manage information about contacts, and keep track of all of the interactions, be it via email, phone call, Twitter, and so on. Businesses in their early stages will be easy to handle without much help. A simple spreadsheet and a bunch of sticky notes will sometimes be sufficient. But as the business grows, you need to get a complete picture on how your business is performing. It's not possible to get that using a bunch of spreadsheets. You will need something more, a tool to kickstart your business with everything you need, and that's Begin. With Begin, you can manage all of the information about your contacts, along with the company to which they belong and the deals that you have with them. With a dedicated pipeline view, you can simply drag and drop deals across the various stages in the sales pipeline, or mark them as won after you have successfully closed them. You can also create multiple sales pipelines to manage different business processes in one place. Stay on top of various activities, such as tasks, events, and phone calls with your customers. You can easily get a list of all of the activities that you have for the day and start completing them one by one. It doesn't end there. You can also analyze various key metrics, such as revenue won in a month, top performing sales rep, list of overdue tasks, and more. Stay connected with your contacts via email and Twitter, and keep track of all of your interactions in a single place. Also, get real-time notifications whenever you receive an email, a DM on Twitter, etc. You can use our inbuilt telephony or integrate your own telephony service to make calls right from Begin. Various routine actions, such as sending welcome emails and assigning tasks to a sales rep, can be automated with the help of workflows. This lets you spend more time on selling and thereby increases your productivity. Apart from the various out-of-the-box features, you can also integrate with other Zoho and third-party applications, such as Google, Zapier, Office 365, Zoho Desk, and more. With the Begin mobile application, you can never miss out on an important appointment or an activity that you have for the day while on the move. Begin, CRM built and priced for small businesses.
Most of the micro or the small businesses still, use spreadsheet for communicating with their customers to keep track of their follow-ups and so on. So keep working with spreadsheet is great, but as your business grows, you get more and more customers, you get more and more sales queries, and you need to follow up with them on a regular basis as well. So to bridge that gap and to make life easier for for the salespeople, we have come up with Zoho Begin. So Zoho Begin is a very simple CRM system, which is primarily focused for small and micro businesses. It is very simple and very simple CRM system, but it comes with a lot of features which will actually help you grow. Your business grow. So as you can see here, it is a pipeline-centric CRM, very minimal in design, which makes it easier for adoption. And it's very easy on the pocket as well, probably the easiest one in the market today. Now, how can Begin actually help your business? So as I mentioned earlier, the user interface and the overall design of Zoho Begin is very simple. That is the reason you will have almost near zero learning curve. So as soon as you sign up with the product, within 30 minutes, you'll be able to set up and start working with it. So it is also scalable as well. So as your business grow, and if you need more and more features, you have always Zoho CRM. So we, you can always upgrade to the CRM if once your business scales and if you're compliant with the latest security standards as well. So you know, you don't have to worry about the data. We are very much compliant with all the latest security standards. So now let's move on to the to few you know, key features that we have in the CRM in Zoho Begin, which will actually help you get started with your sales activities. So first thing we have here is the pipeline view. So once you go to the deals module in Zoho Begin, you can actually picturize your deals based on the stages that they are in. And to move the deals from one stage to another, you actually don't have to edit the deals. You know, you don't have to edit. You can just click on the deal, drag and drop it to one stage from the another. And if you're dealing with multiple business or multiple services, then you can create up to, you know, you can create multiple pipelines up to a maximum of 5. Now you can also customize these stages. So each pipeline might have you know, individual stages specific to them. So you can always customize your pipelines and have your own stages over there. The next feature that we have online here is web forms. So this is basically for your lead generation. So everybody, most of the business uses this. So basically you can create a very simple form in Zoho Begin, which is you know, very simple in Begin. You can create a form, host it on your website, and you can collect information from there. So once the form is hosted, if one of your website visitors go to the website and enter their information there, you know, all those information will get into Begin as one of your contacts. You don't need to learn any coding for that. You just have to drag and drop and build the form and then embed it on your website. You can also add, you know, CAPTCHA and privacy statement as well. So next here is built-in telephony. So once you have a prospect in your CRM or in Begin, the first thing that you do is, you know, you try to engage with them. So the best way of engaging, you know, with your prospect is undoubtedly through a telephone conversation. So with Begin, what we have done is we have integrated a built-in telephony system so that you can, you know, your phone system would be connected to Begin, and you can actually do a click-to-call. So once you have a contact or, you know, here in Begin, you will see a green icon there once your telephony is integrated, and you can just click on that and call that particular prospect or contact and have a conversation with them. So by default, you know, we have a few inbuilt integrations with a few service providers. If you know, you can also integrate with other service providers as well, the ones which are not listed through the PBX vendor. So I'll show you that when we actually move on to the product demo section. So moving to the automation here, the next feature we have is workflows. So workflows basically would actually help you to automate your usual activities that your sales people do. It'll reduce manual work and make sure that there is no error in the system. So basically, you know, if you want to trigger an email or you know, create a task, a follow-up task with your prospects or with your contacts at Begin, you can actually very easily create a workflow in Begin and set a condition. And once the condition matches, once the criteria matches, the workflow would generally be triggered. Apart from these workflows and other features that we have, you know, we also have customized dashboards in Begin. So basically, at the end of the month or at the end of the quarter, if you want to, you know, look at the data, you want to see how much progress you're making as a business, you can always switch to the dashboards that we have in Begin. By default, we have quite a few dashboards, you know, the deal dashboards, the contact dashboards, the email insight dashboard, your task activities dashboard. So you can make use of the default ones, or, you know, if you think that these reports are not sufficient and if you need some more components, you can always create your own charts and add them to the dashboard in Begin. Right. Next, here's the integrations, the current integrations that we have with Zoho Begin. So right now, if you are an Office 365 user and if you want to connect your Zoho Begin with your Office 365 account to sync your contacts and calendar, you can pretty much do that with our Office 365 integration. If you are using Zoho Desk, you know, if you are using Zoho Desk to support your customers to answer their support request, you can actually integrate Zoho Desk with Zoho Begin as well. So once the integration happens with Zoho Desk, you know, when you go to a specific record in Begin, say one of your contacts, you'll be able to see all the support requests that he has submitted so far, he or she has submitted so far. And instead of right from Begin itself, you can see the whole ticket history instead of going to Desk and searching there, right? We also have an integration with Google, so you can integrate your Google Calendar, your Google Contacts with Begin. So if you are a Google user, you know, you can pretty much sync your data with Begin and work from Begin itself. We have an integration. This is a very current one, the recently introduced one with Zoho Meetings. So if you want to engage with any of your contacts through an online meeting, if you want to do a virtual meeting, you can pretty much do that with Zoho Meeting. Similarly, we have an integration with Zoho Card Scanner as well. So if you want to scan business cards and have the entry as a record in Begin, you don't have to do any manual work. You just have to connect your Begin account and scan the business card, and automatically the information would transfer to your Begin account. We have an integration with Zoho Campaigns as well. So if you are doing a lot of email marketing, and if you're already a subscriber of Zoho Campaigns, if you're using the product, then you can actually sync your mailing data with Begin. That way, you know, when you can even see your campaigns from Begin itself, and you can see the overall progress of the campaign. You can see how many people actually attended the campaign, how many of them were responsive, and view other statistics as well. Now we have integration with Zoho Flow, which is another Zoho product, which would actually help you integrate any other Zoho services which are not listed here. So if you are using any other Zoho services, let's say Zoho Books or any other Zoho service, you would be actually able to integrate and sync data through this Zoho Flow option over here. For any other third-party integrations, just like Office 365 or Google, if you are using any other third-party applications, and if you want to connect that with Zoho Begin, you can pretty much do that through Zapier. So now we'll move to the product demo section, and I'll quickly tell you how to get started with Zoho Begin, and we'll show you a few options there as well. So just give me a moment. Let me go ahead and share my screen. Okay, perfect. So let's start with the demonstration over here. So you see these little tabs over here on the left-hand side, we call them modules. So basically I'll start with the contacts module here. Since this is the first module that you will be using for your sales cycle, you know, this is where your prospect and your lead information goes in. So to create a contact in Begin, it's super easy. All you have to do is just click on this contact icon over here and create a contact. So let's create a contact. Perfect. So as simple as that. So this is one of your contacts here, and if you want to change ownership of the contact to anyone else, like if you have multiple users in the organization using Zoho Begin, you can click on this and you can actually change it from here. See, so you can change it very easily from over here. If you want to assign the activities as well, you can just go ahead and check that box and say yes, save. So all the fields that you see here are the default fields in Begin. So mobile, phone, address, location, email address and phone number. Everything's visible over here. Now, if you want to change this, you know, if you want to add your own fields, that is also pretty much doable. You can create your own custom fields and for each of the modules that you have in Begin. I'll show you that as we move ahead. Now, once we create a contact here, so let's say we have a contact here. So once a contact is created, obviously you would try to contact that contact, you know. You would try to either send an email or do a phone call, right? So sending an email is also super easy. You just need to click on this, send email, and you can just mention the subject and send an email right from here itself. All the email interactions that you would have with a contact would be listed here under the emails tab. So all the interactions, the history of your emails will actually be tracked here under the emails, the related list here in the contact modules. Now, the next thing, once you speak to the contact, you know, once you engage with the contact, depending on the conversation, if you feel that the contact is going to do business with you or at least interested to do business with you, you can go ahead and create a deal for the contact. So deals are nothing but your actual sales. This is the module. The deals is where you will actually track your pipeline. So you can easily go to the deals section from here. Click on create a deal. Let's say it's for a phone. So let's name it as phone. The contact would be automatically associated with the deal since you're creating it from within the contact module. You can have your, so now very, you can have your stage here. So different stages for your sales pipeline. All these are, you know, very much customizable. You can rename all these labels that you see under the stage field. So everything is pretty much customizable. So let's say that it is under the qualification stage and add a tentative closing date. Add a product. So let's say this product, and let's say you're gonna have a deal for, let's say, 10 phones. You wanna provide a discount, you can do that as well. So let's say a 5% discount, and save. And save. So right now, once you save the deal, you will actually be able to see it from within the contact itself and from the within the contact record itself. And if this contact comes back to you, say at a later point of time, so let's say after a week or a month to buy something else, you can straight away go here, create another deal and save it here itself. So that way you will have a history of all the deals that you have with this specific contact. Now, once you create this deal over here, this deal would be visible here within the deals module as well. Right. So if you go to the classic view, you would actually see it over here, right? Phone. So with all the information. And if you want to switch back to the pipeline view, you can do it from there. And this is how your deals module would actually look once you switch to the pipeline view. All the deals here, you know, with their specific stages. Now to change the you know, stage of your deal. So let's say that you want to change the stage, or you want to modify the stage for this deal from qualification to price quote. You can actually do that through this drag and drop. See it? So very easy to you know, switch your deals from one stage to another, pretty much doable from here itself. Now again, all these are customizable. You can sort the deals based on the created time, the deal owner amount, pretty much with all the fields that you have in the deals module. So you can use these you know, fields to filter or to sort your data. We have a few predefined views as well. So these are nothing but the predefined views. Closing next month, closing this month, my deals, new last week, new this week. So these are the ones which we give you by default. If you want to create your own you know, view, you can pretty much do that. Just click on create view and you would be able to create your own view from there. Now, when it comes to multiple products, so if you are into a business where you are selling, you know, where you are selling and providing services as well, and if you need specific, you know, specific pipelines to manage those, you can actually go to, you know, you can actually create multiple pipelines from within Begin and switch it from here. So if you want to go to the accessories pipeline, just click on the drop down, click on this, and so basically this will show you all the deals. Depending on what you choose here, will show you all the deals which is associated with that specific pipeline. I'll come back to that when you go to the when we go to the setup you know, settings part. I'll show you actually how to create multiple pipelines and how to work with that, right? So this is how your contact management and your deals management is done with Begin. Pretty simple. Start with the contacts module, and you know, as you make contact or as you engage with your contacts, you can create deals and move the deals with the stages depending on the conversation. So we have the companies module here as well. So basically, when you have a contact, you're maybe you know, sometimes you may have a contact which is an individual, but most of the times it would be contacts from within an organization. So those organizations are actually listed here. So any of your contacts, for example, if I go back to the contact module and open Ted Watson over here, you can see his information here, and you can see his company over here, which says Watson's Professional Services. So when you click on this company, it'll actually take you to the company tab here within the deals module, and this within the companies module. And within the companies module, you'll be actually able to see all the contacts that you have from that specific company, all the deals that are open or closed from the specific company, all the emails, all the notes that you have added for any of the contacts or deals that are associated with the company. So this will give you a clear picture of what's going on with that company, of how much business you're doing and how much you have in the pipeline, and you can plan accordingly based on this view that you see on the company's module. The next module that we have here is the products module. So pretty simple, as the name suggests, you know, you will go ahead and add all the products and services that you provide here in the products module. So very simple to add a product. Just click on the product over here, and you know, just give a product name. So let's say test product. Let's say category. Let's say it's hardware. Can mention a unit price over here. Let's say 5080. Market is active. Let's see. Okay. So once the product is saved, it'll be listed over here. And when you are creating any deal, you will be actually able to associate you know, any of these products which are listed here in the products module. So just keep in mind that if you want to add any product to a deal, you need to make sure that the product is added here in the first place in the products module. The next option here, or the next module here, which we have, is the activities module. So this is where all your activities will get tracked. You know, so start with the tasks. So tasks is pretty simple. It's just like your to-do list. So if you want to, let's say, for example, if you want to email any of your contact at a given day, so let's say if you want to email any of your contact tomorrow, then you can very quickly go ahead, create a task, and set a reminder for the task as well. So let's say task, so follow up, get set a due date, say tomorrow. Set a reminder. If you want to associate with any contact or deal, you can do it from here as well. So, I'm going to associate it with Ted Watson, so I'll click on that. If you want to mark it as high priority, you can check this box. Otherwise, you know, you can just leave it and save. So here's your task. Now, if you want to assign this task to someone else, you can go ahead, edit it, and change the owner to one of the other users that you have. Right? Okay. So this is what tasks would do for you. you know, it will help you to streamline your follow-ups and make sure that you don't miss out on any of them. The next component for the events, for the activities module here, is events. So events is like, you know, if you are going to organize a meeting with a client, a physical meeting or a virtual one, you can go ahead and create an event. So creating an event, simple, just like creating a task, click on the event here, event icon over here. Meeting. Now you can set a start time and an end time. So basically you can say, specify a date over here, any time, and so this is the from time and this is the to time. So starting and ending of the meeting would be actually specified over here. You edit any point of time, you can go ahead and modify that as well. If you want to repeat it, you can, you know, on a weekly basis or on a monthly basis, you can check this box. To set a reminder, you can check it and set the time frame of the reminder as well. So by default, it is set to 5 minutes. You can pretty much go ahead and set it to 15 minutes or 30 minutes based on your you know, requirement over here. And set up, you know, you can specify the location in, location information here as well. If it's an online meeting through Zoho Meeting or any other meeting app, you can just go ahead and you know, just click this option over here. To connect it with any of your contact or any of your deals, you can just go ahead and enter their name over here, and you can associate it. Now, when it comes to event, you know, if you want to invite other participants, you know, external or internal participants, you can pretty much go ahead and click on the participants option over here. Specify their email addresses and hit save. Once that is done, you know, based on the email address that you have specified here, they will actually receive an invitation and they can actually select whether they want to attend it, whether they're interested or not interested. And depending on their input, you will be able to see that on the event itself. So let me save this event. So when you open this event, right here under the participants tab, you'll be able to see how many of them are invited, how many of them has actually accepted it, and how many of them are still thinking about it. So this is actually what events would do for you, would help you set up online or physical meetings, or you know, if you are going to organize or you know, create any conference call situation, that also can be handled through Begin, through events. Now next is your calls. Now, as the name suggests, you know, if you are going to call someone and if you want to track those calls, you know, you want to add some notes and make sure that everything is tracked, you can just go ahead and click a call from here to and from, save like event, start time and end time, set a reminder. If you want to associate it with any of your contacts or deals, you can pretty much do that from here. And your call agenda can also be entered here under the call agenda field, here under the calls module. All right, so that's pretty much about the activities module. Now, all these activities can also be created from within the contacts or the deals module or even the companies module. So for example, if I take you back to the contact module and open up any of my contacts here, now let's say Emily over here, if you want to create an activity or a task for this specific contact, you can pretty much go ahead and click on this activities tab here and click a task, event or call depending on the situation, and you'll be able to save it. Now all the activities that you have done or that you have completed with regards to a specific contact will actually be listed here under the activities related list. So the ones that are striked off are the completed ones. So you can see if you hover over them, you can see that these are all completed and this is the one which is still open. So from once you click on the contact, you view the contact and you'll be able to see how many activities you have completed and how many are yet to be completed from within the contact. Same applies to the deals as well, same thing. You know, you can pretty much go to each and every deal and you can do the same. create a task even to call from right here. The next thing that we are going to, the next feature that we are going to discuss here is the dashboards, right? So at the end of the month or at the end of the quarter or week, we always see how much progress we have done as a team or as a business. So this dashboards in Zoho Begin is going to help you a lot in terms of your KPIs and other stats. So basically, this is how the overview of your dashboard would look like, you know. Contacts created, deals won. Now again, these all components that you see here are pretty much customizable. You know, you can modify them, you can customize them, and you can actually set it up based on your own requirements. So this is the one which is the overview dashboard that we have. Now we also have a few different other, dashboards as well, like predefined ones. So deals, tasks, events, calls, emails, and calls by users. So these are all predefined dashboards that we have. So this is the one it says deals dashboard. You can see over here, you can view your open deals, the deals that you have won, the deals that you have lost, and you can also compare it with the last month. We have a little comparison here as well, which will show you how much your business has grown from last month. Same with the revenue as well. Here you can see your open deals by stages. So basically, you can see your pipeline over here. You can see how many deals you have and on which stages they are on. So this will give you a clear picture of your pipeline. If you want to see how well your users are doing, you can actually make use of this component. So this will show you how much deals has been closed by each of your sales rep on a given interval of time. And same goes with your deals lost as well. So that's pretty much with the dashboard. Now, apart from these predefined ones, you can also go ahead and create your own dashboard here. Just click on a component, either create KPI or create charts. You know, pretty much very simple. Just click on that and click the chart type, and you would be good to go. So now let's move on to the next segment, which is setup and customization. So to customize anything or set up your Begin account, you always have to go ahead and click on this wrench icon over here. Now, the first thing that you need to understand before even Begin account and start using it is roles and profiles. So basically, we have two features here, which is called profiles and roles. The first one will discuss profiles first. So basically, profiles will define, or profiles will will tell what functionalities your users can have access to. So profiles actually controls the functionalities that your users can use, and roles would actually tell what they can see in the CRM, on the record level. So going back to profiles here, we have two profiles, by default, administrator and standard. So in an organization, you might have multiple users, right? So if you have multiple users in the same organization, all of them may not require administrative privileges, right? So maybe the manager or the director can have the administrative privilege, and the sales reps and the others who just need to focus on sales can just have access to the standard profile, which is pretty much restricted. Administrators will be able to do each and everything in this year in Begin. So they can actually view all the records irrespective of what role they are in. They can view everything. They can change or customize almost each and everything in the CRM if they are an administrator. The standard profile, as I said, is a restricted one. It will have limited access. So usually it is given to the sales reps, because they just need to focus on closing deals rather than customizing the account, making some changes within the account. So this is pretty much as far as the default profiles are concerned. Now, if you want to create your own profile with your own set of permissions, that also is pretty much doable. So you can create up to a maximum of 5 profiles. You can go click on new profile here, And you can create your own profile as well. So let's say that I want to create a manager profile. Right, so I can go ahead and clone it from the administrator, click save, and I can define the permissions from here. So if you don't want any of your users, or if you want to set up your profiles, and if you don't want them to make certain changes to the modules, you can actually control it from here. So this will actually tell or define what kind of access functionality wise they would have within that specific module. So if you go ahead and uncheck this option which says edit and delete, then the user who is associated with this profile will actually not able to edit or delete any deep record. So same applies with the other modules as well, and the other functionalities as well. So if you want to turn any of the functionalities for any of the users, you can actually do it from within here. So if you want to turn off workflow automation for any of your users, you can go ahead and turn it off from here and then associate the same profile to that specific user. Same goes with the other, the absolutely same thing for the other functionalities as well. See the profile over here. So let's move on to the roles segment over here. Okay. So as I said, roles will decide what your user can view in the CRM, view in the sense record level. So by default, Begin comes with the CEO and the manager role. So CEO being the higher role will be able to actually view the data that that is associated with the manager. So the idea here is anybody who is in a higher role will actually be able to see data which belongs to a user in the lower role, but not the other way around. So manager actually cannot see any record which is under CEO's ownership, but CEO can actually view records which are associated with a manager. Right. So you can also, if you have multiple hierarchies in your organization, you can actually create roles as well. So if you want to create a custom role, you can just go here and click on the new role icon. Say, I'm going to say it as sales rep and make it report to the manager. Now this is very important here. So this checkbox will actually decide whether the users in the same role can view their data or not. So if you are having let's say 4 or 5 sales rep under the same profile, and if you want them to see each other's data, if you want them to view each other's data, then you can go ahead and check this box. Otherwise, if you just want them to manage their own data and take care of their own data, you can pretty much uncheck this box, which would again restrict them from viewing each other's data, and then save it. All right. So now you can see the sales rep role is added over here. So as I said, the manager would be able to view the data which is associated with a sales rep, but not the other way around. So moving ahead to the users segment over here. So right now in this account, I have 2 users. So when you start your Begin account, by default, you will have your name listed over here as one of the users, which would be the super admin. If you want to add additional users, so if you buy additional licenses and if you want to add additional users, you can pretty much go ahead and click on the new user tab over here, select any name. So let's say names and now this is basically you have to specify your the first name, the last name of the person that you are going to add in your Begin account, then their email address has to be listed here. Now this is where you define their role. So when you add any of the users in your Begin account, you need to assign a role to them. So depending on what role they are having in the organization, whether they are a manager or a sales rep or whatever role it might be, you have to go ahead and select the appropriate role from here. So if I'm going to add a sales rep, I'll go ahead and say sales rep and say standard. So remember profiles, by default we have the administrator and standard profiles. This is the one which I created. Now if you want them to have limited access to the database, if you want them to do a certain not do certain functionalities like deleting any record or exporting any data out of the begin account, then you can pretty much go ahead and restrict them by giving them the standard profile. If you want them to have access to the complete database and want them to make changes there, you can go ahead and make them the administrator. So once you click on invite user, invitation will be sent to that specific email address that you have specified while adding the user. And depending, like the user just have to go to the invitation, click on the link, and then they'll be redirected to this, to your begin account. So the questions are already answered. So let's move ahead. So the next options or the next thing that we are going to see here in Begin is your fields and layout. So as I said, while explaining the contacts module, I've mentioned that, you can always go ahead and add your own custom fields. So by default, we give you certain fields. So let's select the contacts module here. So these are the default fields that we have in the contacts module, which comes to go, when you sign up with the product, these are the fields that it comes with. Now, if you want to add any more fields, so let's say that if you want to add another phone number field, so in that case, you would actually just go ahead and create a custom field. Right. So while creating the custom field, you just have to keep in mind, you have to keep in mind or you have to understand what type of data you are going to capture. For example, if it's going to be an additional email field, if it's going to be an email field, I would go ahead and select it as an email. Right. So same thing, if it's going to be a phone field, so to capture phone number, go ahead and select the appropriate type. Right. So you can actually make them mandatory if you want your users to fill that specific field. You can mark it as mandatory. You can also use that field as a duplicate check. If you don't want records to have the same value for this field, you can go ahead and check this box. And if you want to encrypt the data, you can check this box as well. So these are all optional. Save. Right. So you have the phone field here listed over here. Now, if I go back to the contacts module, and if I am creating a new contact, I can see the phone field. It is under additional information section, but you can rename this as that as well. So here is your additional phone number field right here. And the same applies to other fields as well. So anytime if you want to create additional fields in the Begin account, you just have to go to the wrench icon here, go to fields, select the module that you want to customize, whether deals, contacts, companies, products, or activities. Select that specific module and click on the custom field option, which is over here. Okay. Any questions? Let's see if we have any questions on field level customization. All right. So the next customization options that we have here in Begin is your pipeline and stage customization. So this is related to the deals module where all your sales are getting tracked. So if you go to the pipeline and stages over here, you can see I have got like three different pipelines over here. You can create a maximum of five pipelines. So again, if you are dealing with multiple products or dealing with multiple services, and if you want to have separate or individual pipelines for each of them, you can pretty much go ahead and create your own pipeline, have your own stages for those pipelines, and save it from here. So you can pretty much create another pipeline just by clicking on this new pipeline option. So click on new pipeline, and you can add your own pipeline over here. So let's say if I'm going to add pipeline for instance, so I can just make it as you can pretty much go ahead and add your own values here by clicking on this plus icon. So you can add different stages to your pipeline using this option over here. And if you want to delete any of, at any point of time, if you want to delete any of your stages, you can just go to setup. I'll take you there again. So basically go to setup, go to pipeline and stages under the settings tab, and click on that specific pipeline. So if you want to remove this follow-up stage from this pipeline, which says services, you just need to click on the pencil icon over here and say delete, and then save it. So the same thing applies if you want to add any specific stage as well. Just go to that specific pipeline, click on the edit icon and add from there, or you can easily add from here as well, from the plus stage over here. All right. So this is how you manage your pipeline in Begin. A maximum of 5 pipelines again can be created in Begin, and you will be able to streamline your deals based on the pipelines and the stages very, very easily from within Begin. The next feature which I've already discussed is web forms. So again, web forms are pretty much essential for you when it comes to lead generation. So you don't require any coding here to create a form and host it on your website. So you just go to the web form section over here from within the settings and click on new web form. Right. So you can drag and drop the fields that you would like to capture in the web form. So if you want to capture email address, just add it here. If you want to capture their address information, you can just drag and drop from here, right? So you can add as many as as many fields as you want. Just drag and drop, enter a form name. So let's say, go to next step. So this is the form name, the form location URL. So this is the URL where your form is supposed to be hosted. So if you are going to host it on your website, you need to specify the URL of your website over here. The landing page URL is usually the thank you page. So basically when a visitor fills the web form and clicks on submit, they're usually redirected to a thank you page. So the URL of that thank you page can be specified over here. And if you want to assign those contacts coming from the web form to any specific user, you can actually select it from this drop down over here. So if you want any other user, just switch it from here. And if you want to notify them through an email, you can check this box. If you want to add a tag to them, to those records, you can actually do it from here. If you want to acknowledge the visitor, if you want to drop them an acknowledgement email post submission, you can actually turn acknowledgement visitor from here. And request approval is actually to manage to make sure that you don't get any junk entries. So if you turn on request for approval, all the information that is getting captured from the web forms, instead of going to the contacts module directly, it will go to the approve section, from where you'll be able to see them and you'll be able to validate and approve them from within the approved section, right? So once you hit save next over here, you will see a source code, a code over there. All you need to do is just copy that code and embed it on your website. Once that is done, your form will be up and running, and all the information that has been entered in the form will actually be transferred to the contacts module in Bigin. So if you go back to contacts module over here, and if you go to this section, approve contacts, you see it over here. So if approval is turned on, all your contacts will actually coming in from the web form will actually sit under this option here, approve contacts. So you can actually see them, validate them, and then approve them right from here itself. So going back to setting again. So that's pretty much with the web forms. Now let's have a look at the workflow automation that we have in Bigin. Right. So with Bigin, you'll be able to automate certain manual things that you do on a regular basis. So for example, if you want to send a welcome email to your contacts, anytime if you want to send a welcome email to any of your contacts, whenever they are entered in Bigin, you can pretty much do it from workflow. So instead of entering the contact in Bigin, contact information, and then going back to send email and then sending an email, you can actually automate that whole thing over here. The same goes with your activities as well. So if you want your sales rep to call any of your contacts, let's say if you want to do a follow-up call to your contacts the next day when they're added in Bigin, you can pretty much do that as well using workflows. Instead of going to the contact and creating a manual activity, you can actually automate it using workflow. So let's see how a simple automation or workflow automation can be set up using Zoho Bigin. So click on new workflow here. So let's say that I want to create a workflow for my contacts, and I want to trigger an email or create a task for them, a follow-up task for them whenever they're entered in Bigin. So I'll go ahead and select the modulus contact. So anytime you're creating a workflow, if you're creating it for a specific module, that module has to be selected from the list of modules over here. Right? So let's say contacts module, the workflow name, so let's say follow up. Click on next. Right. So this is the idea here is to create a task for one of my sales rep as soon as a new contact is entered in my Bigin account. So I'll have it triggered on based on create. You can also do it based on edit or create or edit. So these are additional trigger options that we have. So for my scenario, I'll select created. I'll go next and set up a condition. So if you want to run this or trigger this workflow only to a specific set of contacts, to a specific group of contacts, then you can set up a criteria over here. So criteria can be anything. So all the fields are listed here. You can use any of these fields to set up a criteria. If you want it to be triggered for all of your contacts, which is there in the database, you can just go ahead, click on all contacts. So go next. So this is where you specify your actions. So we have defined the trigger and the condition. Now we are going to define the action and say to the system what it has to do once the condition is or condition or the criteria is met. So if I want to create a task, so we have different actions over here: email, task, update, and tag. So since I'm going to create a follow-up task for my sales rep, I'll choose the task option over here, create a task. Set an owner. Right, so it can be any of the owners, so choose from here. If you want to set the priority to high, low, or normal, you can pick it from this drop-down over here, let's say normal. So as I said, I want this initial follow-up task to be you know, completed by the second day. So what I would do is, and if you want to set a reminder, you can do that as well, and then save, right? And then save the workflow. So once the workflow is saved, you know, you'll be able to see it over here under the follow up option, and under the workflows it's listed as follow up. So you click on the, let's go ahead and click on the contacts module and see how it actually works. So I'm going to create a fresh contact over here, a very new contact from here. So say that. .com and save it right now. See, so automatically upon save, so once I saved this contact record, you can see there is a task automatically which got generated automatically here under the activities section. So this is what the workflow actually would do for you. You can automate certain things from within Begin, and you know, which will reduce your manual work, and your you can actually focus on selling, and rather than you know, create doing all these manual activities. So as I said, you can trigger workflows and you know, create tasks. You can send emails to them. You can update any of the fields. So if you want to update any of the fields based on a certain condition, you can do that as well. If you want to categorize your contacts and add a tag, you can do that as well using workflows. So, you know, all these options are pretty much open. All you need to do is just go to setup, go to workflows, and start creating one, right? So let's have a look at the data administration. So with Begin, we also give you an option to you know, import data from spreadsheets. So what we see today is most of the business are using spreadsheets. And if you want to migrate to a CRM system like Begin from a spreadsheet, it's pretty much simple. All you need to do is you know, go to your contacts module here or the deals module. And if you want to import a file, you just need to click on import contacts over here. So you click on import contacts. It will ask you to select the file. All you need to do from here is select the file, map the columns and the fields that we have in Begin so that the data goes to the right field based on the mapping. And once that is done, click on upload. Once the you know, file is uploaded, everything will be listed over here. And if you want to check the result of the import, if you want to see how many of the records actually got imported, how many got skipped off, you can actually go to data administration, and under import history, you'll be able to see how many got imported from that specific file, how many got skipped, and what is the reason behind skipping all those files from your spreadsheet. Same thing goes with data export as well. You can select a module and export your data. So if you want to export any of your modules, let's say deals or contacts or companies, you can, or products in that case, you can just go ahead and select from here and click on export. So data backup, when you sign up with Begin, you know, we actually give you a couple of data backups per month. So you can schedule a data backup, and you know, every month twice will give you a data backup free of cost. If you want additional data backup, then you know, there'll be a nominal charge of $5 for each backup. Recycle bin is the name suggests. So if you delete any record, you know, from the Begin account, whether a contact or a deal or a company, that record will actually go to the recycle bin. And you can actually go to the recycle bin and see if you want to, at any point of time, if you want to restore that data, you can go to the recycle bin and restore it from here. You know, it will stay there for 60 days in recycle bin. You'll be able to restore it within 60 days. You know, so pretty much just like the regular recycle bin options that we have in other applications. And we also have an audit log, which will show you all the activities that has been done in your Begin account by any of the users in the organization. So you can go to the audit log as an administrator, and if you want to see what changes has been done, you can pretty much see along with the timestamp and the user signature as well, right here from the audit log. The next thing here is the storage. So here you can see the storage that you have, the file storage that, or the record storage that you have consumed so far as an organization. So by default, you will see the allowed storage over here, and the consumed storage will be listed over here. We have also broken it down based on the users. So if you want to see based on the users, you can always go to the storage option and it will be listed over here. Now, this we have already discussed the predefined or the out of the box integrations that we have with BigIn, so Google, Zapier, Office 365, Zoho Campaigns, and Zoho Meeting. All right. So for your customer engagement, so when you engage with your customer, whether it's an email or a phone call or a social, we have all those fields covered. You can do an IMAP integration within CRM. So if you are using any other service provider, email service provider, and if you are if you want to track those emails, if you want to keep everything in one single platform, you can always go ahead and do an IMAP integration with your email. So by default, Zoho Mail, Gmail, and Office 365 is available. If you want to add any other service provider, you can do that as well using the other mail option. Same goes with social as well. We have integration with Twitter, so you can actually connect your official Twitter account, your organization's page in Twitter, and you can see all your social interactions, the people who are tweeting, retweeting, or commenting on your post. Thing goes with your PBX services as well. So as I told earlier, we have got inbuilt PBX, inbuilt telephony in BigIn. So you can set it up right from here. So click on setup phone. Right, if you want to do it from the marketplace, so marketplace.zoho.com, that is where we all our integrations are listed out. So you can go to marketplace and select any of the vendors listed from the marketplace. If you want to have your own connection, if you want to have your own PBX service provider connected, then you can go ahead and select this option which says custom PBX provider. Now, going back to the emails, just wanted to tell or share something with you guys here. So we have something called Email Insights as well. So basically, if you're sending out emails and if you want to track those emails, if you want to see the responses, if you want to see whether the email got bounced back or whether the email has been opened or whether it has been delivered, you can actually do that in BigIn. You can turn on the Email Insights. And once it is turned on, your emails actually will be tracked. You'll be able to see whether they're opened or clicked, whether they bounced or, basically you'll be able to see the statuses of all your emails. So we have the signals option here under channels, which is nothing but the little icon which you see here on the top right hand corner. So anytime an email is opened or clicked or bounced, you'll get a signal over here from this icon, and kind of like a notification. And you'll also get if some call is missed, if there is a new ticket entry from Zoho Desk, if there is some mention in Twitter. So all of them can be specified over here. You can check the boxes from here based on what you want to get notified on. And once you save that, your signals will be visible from here. Okay, so I'm gonna wrap up the demonstration now and move on to the presentation again. Just give me 1 second. So before we wrap up today's session, I just wanted to share this with you, with all of you here. So we have a few features which are in our roadmap along with the tentative release dates over here. So we are, you know, our roadmap is, you know, we have a pretty busy schedule here. So you can see a few of the upcoming features that we have. So CRM to begin migration. So you'll be able to seamlessly migrate from Zoho CRM to begin along with your contacts, notes, activities, and all historical data. You'll be able to migrate to begin, and that's starting, that will be available by the end of this week or by next week. So this has been, you know, this has, we are working on this as we received a lot of requests where customers, you know, wanted to manage their pipeline in begin and do the other stuff from the CRM. So this is actually going to help. This Zoho CRM integration. This is going to help those customers who want to manage their pipeline in begin and do the other activities from within the CRM. So this is going to get released by the end of August. Same goes with Zoho Forms integration. We are developing integrations for Zoho Forms, Zoho Sites, and Zoho Books integration also is on the pipeline and should be available by September end. We are also going to revamp the pipeline view, which with a few other options by September end. And we are also giving you certain customizations options, which are not available right now. For example, right now, you cannot rename modules or reorder fields in begin. Now that is going to be possible by September end once this feature is released now. So, we are also releasing good news for the third-party integration. So if you want to integrate your third-party apps with Zoho Begin, good news for you all. So we are going to release Begin APIs by September end. So post which you will be able to connect any third-party system with Zoho Begin. We are also working on MailChimp integration. So we already have an integration with Zoho Campaigns, right? So you can actually sync all your, you know, all your contacts from Zoho Campaigns to Zoho Begin, and you can, you know, sync data and do your email marketing from within Zoho Campaigns and see those results in Zoho Begin as well. So that's, you know, that's already there, but MailChimp is something which we have got a lot of request for, and this is going to be released by the end of September. So next one is the RTL support, the right to left support. So this is specifically designed for our Middle East and North African customers, keeping them in mind. So if you are using Arabic or Hebrew, you will be actually able to use the begin in a very efficient way with the, you know, right to left you know, screen orientation. So that's all from my end as far the today's session is concerned.